Hello, all the friends of Cosmic Agency. I am Gosha. Today is a short and interesting, exciting video with an important update which I will leave for the rest of this video. But before, just a very, very, very brief update. Someone was complaining some time ago about that, about the grammar that is not used properly in some of the texts. And how is that possible? And well, and I have to explain here that some of the information that is given in English. And then if it's given in English, I have to translate this into Spanish. They don't do that. I do. And you have to remember that none of these languages are my languages. So when I receive the information from them in English, I translate into Spanish with the Google Translate, but then I go over it, every sentence, and I translate. And I correct the mistakes, but according to my understanding of Spanish, which I know is lacking. And then if there is information given in Spanish, then that would be the most correct information. But then I have to translate it into English. So again, I might commit some errors. I may make mistakes. So whatever mistakes you see in grammar or in structures of the sentences, it's on me. It's on me. Whatever mistakes they make, I noticed is typos, usually, because they write very fast and they try to transmit all this big amount of information very fast, and then they make some typos which I have to correct. But any other bigger mistakes, grammatical or syntax, anything like that, is on me. It's my mistakes in the translations. Well, just that on that. Now, the next thing I want to mention is that, as I said before, we will be here at the conference in the in Finland, in the south of Finland. It's going to be a three-day UFO seminar, and Robert and myself will be there giving our presentations, and Matthias will be translating. So if you are in the area, you are welcome to join us. And on the 1st of September, I'm going to publish an interview that was taken here in the Finnish YouTube channel, but it's going to be in English. It's going to be myself, and then at the end also Matthias will join us for that interview. So on the 1st of September, when it comes out, I'm going to publish that link. Now, as you noticed, my second part of the video about the Vatican was removed by YouTube, and I'm quite surprised that it was removed that fast, because yes, I have videos removed. I do, I always say that. It's not that easy, and there is censorship of my channel, both channels, and Robert channels as well. I always say that. It's just that those videos that they remove are usually like from 6 months back or whatever, so that's why I don't even mention it, you don't even notice it. But yes, there is censorship of my channel, because many people say, oh, how can you stay online? How do you stay online? How come you don't get censored? I do get censored all the time. And that's why I created the second backup channel, Cosmic Agency 2, and that's why I have an account on before Libri and now Odyssey, which is a censorship-free platform where I publish all these videos that cannot go to YouTube or which are removed from YouTube. So please sign up to the Cosmic Agency number 2 just in case. And I will continue working, and whatever information I had that is sensitive, like right now, this is the first time I received a warning, and removal of the video was executed because of cyberbullying. And the reason was it wasn't even given exactly. I have no idea which part exactly was bullying and who. I can only assume. But anyway, now that I know, because before the videos were removed because of the medical disinformation. So that's why all these medical videos I usually put on another platform right away. But here, this is the first time that I'm receiving this for cyberbullying. So now I have to be careful with that. But that's that on that topic. Now, I would like to mention something about the famous now topic of exopolitics. Because this is something that I myself was very interested in long before we got this experience with the Tegetans and with the Zvarunians. And I was following very much different people who were publishing and sharing information in the topics of so-called exopolitics. But as I was reviewing chats with Aneka from some time ago, because part of my tasks every day is to go through all these past conversations and still take out what I can use. So the topic of exopolitics was mentioned, and she was explaining how the whole idea of exopolitics, as it is understood here on Earth, has been developed here on Earth exclusively. These are ideas based on our own human ideas, mostly, and it does not reflect how things in reality outside Earth are and how the Federation views the management of the situation between humans and Earth. And she was very clear on the fact that most of that information is just disinformation, unfortunately. A lot of those ideas floating around there about, you know, political interactions, supposed interactions between the Federation and the humans. A lot of ideas that we create in that area of exopolitics is that, you know, that are based on how we understand politics here on Earth. So we imagine that the leaders of the Federation will be talking to the leaders of the human society, and that's not how it is. First of all, the Federation doesn't even see the same leaders on Earth as we perceive them to be leaders. And here I'm referring to the politicians, for example. They don't perceive them as leaders. They perceive them as puppets of a deeper structure. They are not even interested in talking to so-called deep state level, because that's just a very superficial level, just beyond the official political layer. Unfortunately, who they do perceive as leaders and someone to talk to on Earth, as it was explained in the video about the Vatican, are the leaders of the deep, deep, deep layers of the secret societies and Illuminati. And I know this is disconcerting, and I know this is something we do not like and do not maybe even understand, but that's who they talk to mostly, and sometimes with the politicians when it is convenient to them, depending on each specific case. So there are many scholars out there who talk about the diplomatic relationships that are developing between the Federation and between the humans. However, as Aneka explained in that conversation, is that this is not happening. It's just not how it is. It's not. This is just a pure and direct reflection of how we perceive that it would be, how we perceive that it should be done, or how it is, because this is how it's done on Earth. But the perception of the reality from the Federation point of view is so vastly different. Like, for example, they know from the Federation level that we here are not this body. Many times, many of these so-called diplomats or whatever who supposedly talk to the Federation, they have their 5D equivalents somewhere there in the immersion pods, or sometimes even at the same time here and there, that the Federation doesn't have any need, or it doesn't have any desire or goals to talk to their 3D equivalents. So that is completely misunderstood and overlooked by humans, by people, that aspect of the reality, just because sometimes we just don't even know that this is the reality. So we impose our own ideas of how the relationship should be and how the diplomatic interactions occur between the Federation and the humans. But Aneka was super clear, this is not how it's happening at all. And many, if not most of these ideas running through the exopolitical movements on Earth are just simply and sincerely not true. All these structures, political and social structures, that we recognize here on Earth as democratic, republican parties, and presidents elects and all that, this is completely not how the Federation views the real power structure on Earth. They know from that level that this is all a farce. They see through that system, and they know this is just a front for the people. So they're not going to be talking to that fake level of the power structure. They're going to be talking to the deeper power structure, as I said in the beginning. As Aneka explained, normal people on Earth, the human population, does not talk to the Federation leaders. They do not participate in any reunions and any meetings and any negotiations. The Federation leaders don't talk to those people because those people are not in charge of anything and of what's really happening on Earth. So they are not wasting time on those people. Now, I'm not saying this is how it should be. I'm not defending and justifying the Federation. I'm just saying this is how they think. So unfortunately, a lot of what many ufologists, renowned even ufologists, speak about in this subject is simply based simply on their own interpretation of how things are with the earthly lens, and has absolutely no basis on reality. So that exopolitics simply has no basis in real life. So I just wanted to share that with you very fast. When I read that, I thought this was important, because the exopolitical movement is quite big, and there are a lot of people who follow that, but you just have to keep what I said in mind. Now, let's go to our update. This is very exciting. This is very, 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 very important. And the news is that, yes, we have a Tigetan ship. We have a Tigetan ship in the orbit right now. Athena has informed us that yesterday, or I don't know, I'm very bad with what day we have today. On the 29th of August, there arrived a heavy cruiser from Taygeta. It's called Ventra, and it is a scientific ship. It comes in the representation of Taygeta and Arsionic Council, and it has a full crew on board. It has its own crew on board. So we have again the Taygeta ship in the orbit, heavy cruiser. Taygeta again has its presence here around Earth. I thought that might be of your interest. I'm very excited about this news. And let's see what happens forward. The next two videos that I have to share with you are going to be inspirational videos presented by Jaski Sofia Zvaru. And it's kind of in relation to what kind of attitude you should have now in the face of all this information about the Federation, about the Cabal, you know, and everything that's happening in the world right now. So there's going to be some advice, some push, some energy, some motivation for you there. Thank you very much for watching. That's all I will say here at this point. That's all I have for you today. And we'll see each other. Oh, in the next video also, I forgot to mention, it's going to be just a short video that I recovered from the past, from Robert's videos about Nibiru. About Nibiru, very fast. Because many people are asking, what is this Nibiru? Is it really true that it's there? Planet X and all that. So I translated the video that Robert made on the subject a while back. It was actually part of the conversation was with Eridania. Who was the captain, and then the rest of the information is given by Zvaru 9. So you'll understand once and for all, from our perspective, what is the deal with this whole Nibiru planet. Well, thank you very much for watching again, and I will see you next time. Thank you.